Hi everyone, it's Becca, and today I'm back on behalf of Wild Orchid Crafts, the Wild Bunch, to share another project with you guys, so I hope you enjoy.
Hey guys! Today I'm here to share a couple of cards that I've made with you all. I am absolutely in love with these cards. I just think that they turned out so cute, and I really hope you guys are gonna like it too. I have made these cards using the romance novel by Prima. I just really wanted to show you guys that with the Wild Orchid Craft product, you can really get completely different looks. It can really go from like something very romantic, girly, pink kind of colors to something more elegant, like this black and yellow card. So, as always, I'll have all of the product codes down below in the description box for you to go and check out from the Wild Orchid Crafts website. I'll show you this pink one first. So they're both easel cards, and the easel card, as you know, stands up like this. So the first thing I did was I just used some paper on the background. I also used the beautiful doily, and it's just peeking through right here. I've used some of this beautiful guipure lace from Wild Orchid Crafts. This is in the white. Then I've added this cute little bow on the side, and this is using pink salmon vintage seam binding. I've also used some of these white pearl stamens, and I've used one of these square-shaped silver buckles. And to top that, I've used one of these 12 mm pink pearl. I've used some of these baby pink calla lily flowers on the back right here. I've got three of them. And this is the two-tone baby pink heather flowers. And I love using those for cards because they're small, but they add a lot of interest to the card. I've used this Eiffel Tower die, and this was actually a gift from a friend, so I really love that. I like how that turned out. And then next to my Eiffel Tower here, I've added some of these white with baby pink center sweetheart blossoms. I inked the edges with some brown ink just to give it a bit of a distressed look. I've also added this paper clip, which is a heart-shaped paper clip, and I tied a little bit of the same seam binding onto the paper clip, and it just looks like that. And then I added some bling just on certain areas just to finish off the front of the card. Then on the inside, this is what I did. So I added some more paper on the background, and then I added a little bit more of that lace. I just really love this lace. It's so delicate and so beautiful. So I added some on the top and the bottom. I've used some more of that same seam binding, and this is actually what's going to stop the easel card from falling down. So I've created this beautiful bow here, and you can see how dimensional that is. And then I added another one of those sweetheart blossoms in the center. So basically, this is how it would work. It just stands up like this. And then from the side, this is what you would see. And this is how the card would look on the mantelpiece. So really, really beautiful. So that's card number one. Card number two, I've used a similar way to create the background, but I did use different papers and different embellishments and colors, of course. So this here is actually a birthday card. So I stamped my sentiment in the center here. I just stamped happy twice, so happy, happy birthday. And then I've added some of this beautiful cream guipure lace going across, like so. I also have a doily here on the back, and it's just peeking through as well. Then I added this double bow using the vintage seam binding in antique gold. And I actually think that this works really well if you're using it as a gold seam binding, but it also works really well as a yellow seam binding. As you can see here, it really coordinates really nicely with the paper and the other embellishments. In the center, I have another one of those square silver buckles. I've got one of these cream pearl circle buckles from Wild Orchid Crafts, and then I've used one of these flat back pearls, which was from my stash, as a smaller pearl to go in the center. And then down here, I have one of these beautiful flowers, and it comes from the mixed color tea roses in 25 mm, and it's white and yellow, and you have a variety of colors in that pack as well. Then here I have one of these cherry blossoms. This one is the white, but it actually comes from the pack of mixed pastel colored cherry blossoms. I've also got one of these sweetheart blossoms down here, which comes from the mixed color sweetheart blossoms. I also have another one up here actually. And then I've also used some of the mixed white and cream hip rosebuds on the top here. So I've got three going on. On the back here, I've got one of these Gypsophila on a stem flowers on the back, and I've used the yellow one. And I also have some of these heather flowers in the white. So I've got two. And I actually bent it a little bit so that it gives a little bit more of an interest. Down here, I've got some more of those white pearl stamens. And I also added some more of that lace on the top. And then I just finished off the card with some bling on certain areas of the card. And also this little balloon, which is from the same collection that the paper came from. And that finishes off the front of the card. And then on the inside, I did something similar to the other card, except I've added some of these beautiful yellow balloons. And these come from the mixed color summer balloons. The larger one is the 4.5 centimeter, and the smaller one is the 3 centimeters. And I also added some more of those pearl stamens in the center of the flower, so it looks like that. The bow I created in the same way as the one before, and just using the same seam binding as I used for the front of the card. And then I've got another one of those sweetheart blossoms right here in the center. And so the card stands up in the same way. And of course, because this one has the flowers, you kind of have to place the card in between the two flowers, as you can see here. And this is how the card would stand up. And that's what you would see from the side. And so that finishes off the second card. I really, really hope you guys like this project. I would love to hear which one is your favorite. Do you like the yellow with black theme, or do you like the Parisian girly pink kind of colors? So yeah, just comment below and let me know. Thank you all so much for watching. I will catch you guys next time. Bye!